be a chef at a restaurant, right? But it does not, that does not allow me, give me the time I need to be able to do this podcast correctly, right? So one thing at a time, Dave, get the podcast going, and then you can open your restaurant. Because that ego side, right, the negative ego side is like, hey, man, like, you should be a chef right now. You should be leading a team. You should be feeding that ego, that you're the man of the place, that you get, you know what I mean? And that's not the right reason to do it. So I'm going to slow it down. I will have my restaurant, but I don't know when, you know? And it's going to be a sick concept. It's going to be a fucking fire in the middle. Seats around, probably like 14 seats around. Cooks serving. Chef cooking and serving as well. Having a great time. Loud music. Puerto Rican influence, seasonal fucking cuisine from farms and farms only. And it's going to be called Muerte. Because it's the ultimate consequence. You know? And that's a dream. And that's achievable. And to help Puerto Rico as well. You know. Regain their agricultural strength in this world. So that millionaires from all over the world don't come and reap the benefits of the fucking island because corrupt ass motherfuckers put laws in place so the poor get fucked over constantly and the rich can make money and just make more and more money, you know? I talked about this a lot on the road trip. It's like, what is success? Success is different for everybody. And I know that people talk about the ultimate goal being money. And unfortunately, that is a big part of success, you know. But success is being truly happy with yourself. That's true success. And once you gain that, you can get the money, I promise you. But you need to be happy in what you're doing, and you need to do it for you. Not your family, not your friends, for you. Obviously, if you have kids, you got to do it for them because you got no fucking choice. But make sure that you're doing what makes you happy, man. There's nothing worse. I heard a lot of times when I would meet random people in the street and I'd tell them what I was doing, they go, oh, I wish I could do that. You fucking can. You can do this. It's not that hard. You know? All it takes is a fucking willingness to be uncomfortable, to sleep in a Camaro sometimes, you know, which is not fucking easy, guys. I'm 6'2". That shit ain't easy. But that's the shit that I had to do, you know? So, New Orleans, I dropped Trey Smith and Blake Aguilar, who are best new chefs this year. That's three best new chefs in one podcast road tour. Angel Barreto, Trey Smith, and Blake Aguilar. And at this time, I got back to when I went to Austin, I also talked to Furman, who's also a best new chef, same class. So four best new chefs. That's fucking dope, man. That's cool. You know, like, you want to nerd out about fucking chefs and cooking? Like, yeah, it's fucking cool. You know, like, that's, this podcast is cool. But crying out loud here, am I the only one that thinks that? Jesus. Probably. I don't know. You know, I can only think back and, like, you know, part of my process for this podcast is not editing it. Because I never want to be unreal. If I'm wrong, I want to be wrong and I want you to correct me. I want you to help me see the light. Or, you know what, don't listen to the podcast. You know, like, I really can't help that, you know. But again, if I said anything that's like remotely offensive to anybody or you have a different opinion, let's talk about it, bro. I'm down. I will read your email out loud, live. Live. All right? So I dropped the New Orleans episodes. Right. So the next wave of episodes would be the Houston, Justin Yu one, and Fermin Nunez, and also Kevin Fink, and I'm forgetting his goddamn name, Dave. What the fuck? Don't do that shit. Chef Tavel Bristol. These fucking guys own so many restaurants. Emmer and Rye, Henbit, TLV, Hestia, Kalimotso, Kanji. I went to Kanji, and that's all I hit on their list. But Kevin Fink, man, like, they sat down and they were like, who the fuck are you to me, you know? And I was like, oh, shit. And I re-listened to it, man, and I'm happy that I was able to sit there and, like, talk about my position in life and talk about the things that I was passionate about and the goals that I had. Because before then, I don't really think I said it out loud to anybody. So again, that Kevin Fink and Tavel Bristol episode that I did in Austin, check that out, man. In the first few 5 minutes, you can really get a taste of what Sucio Talk's all about. Then I dropped Gray Nonas. Shout out to Gray Nonas. We did a fucking potluck dinner together in Austin. Fucking dope. And then I dropped the Nephi Craig episode, which was at the White Mountain Apache Reservation, which I talked extensively about. Good ass dude. Fucking awesome. So shit was dope. Oh, and I forgot to say that when I went to LA, I actually interviewed Chef Kat and Chef John of Yangban Society. I've been helping out there. I helped them open, and now I'm back in LA helping them out again. Just, you know, staffing's low. And I'm proud of them, man. I'm proud of true friends that really are opening their own restaurant. Like, that's always the goal of people who start cooking. You know what I mean? They want to have their own spot. And it's super cool to go in there and hear their music over the loudspeaker and see this place that's like a whole new concept. It's a fucking super, like, it's got Korean snacks and fucking merch. And then you can order from the deli to go for here. And then you can order specials from the kitchen. I mean, it is fucking badass. It's a badass space. They invented a whole new cuisine. Korean Jewish deli. When have you ever fucking heard of that? You've never heard of that shit because they invented it. And put some respect on the name, man. Chef Kat, first female CDC at a 3-star restaurant. Restaurant in Meadowood. Put that in the motherfucking history books because I feel like people forget. And then her husband takes over after her. What a fucking dynasty. Like, what a fucking... You know what I'm saying? Michael Jordan and fucking... In 94 or whatever fucking year it was. Just a great team. And now they're opening their own restaurant. And I got to help with that. My mentors, the people that taught me at fucking Meadowood. Like, dude. All that shit's important. All of it. And they finally did the podcast with me. It's been like a year I've been trying to get them on. But we had a great time, you know. And Chef Costello told me that he listened to the episode. And he felt, you know... that we were having fun. He said he laughed, he cried, you know, he really had a great time listening to it. And that's what I love. When people want to get in the conversation that we're having on Sucio Talk or respond to me when I'm just talking and rambling, like, that's fucking cool, you know? And I look at my statistics every day. I see how many people download it, you know, on a daily basis. And I got to say, I thank you. Because I'm always like, okay, 74 downloads. It's like, grateful that 74 people got up today and they thought of Sucio Talk enough to go on the phone, open up the app, find the fucking show and play it and listen to it and give it time. So once again, super appreciative. At that time, that's when I did the podcast with John Trox. Then I did one with the Oco Supper Club boys, Solomon Johnson and Mikey Woods. And then I went up to Sebastopol and talked to my boy Sam Levy. Basically single-handedly formed the beverage program at the restaurant at Meadowood and the Charter Oak. So fucking badass dude. He has a fern bar in Sebastopol. He's raising a little daughter. His chef's, his Fucking wife's name is Victoria. Super cool. Sam that worked at Meadowood with me as well. Fucking really knowledgeable people. Fucking amazing, amazing people. So shout out to them. And yeah, so, you know, the road trip was fantastic. I had one of the greatest times of my life doing it. And, you know, I'm definitely going to do it again. We'll have to figure out a time and a place. There's a couple places that have been reaching out, like, yo, come through. Baltimore, Ann Arbor, Michigan, Detroit, Minneapolis, Minnesota, like all these places that have these great restaurants that, you know, they're not on our radar. If you're not in LA or New York, it's like not on the fucking radar, and it's fucking sad. Like, let's go, man. Let's put these stories out there. Let's be more aggressive about people knowing about these restaurants, because we might entice more people to come into the restaurant industry, you know, to actually want to become chefs and want to do it as a career. You know, it's such a transient career sometimes, like, especially here in LA, everybody's trying to be an actor and shit. It's like, God damn it. Where the fuck are the career servers at, son? You know, because that's a real fucking job, and it's respectable. You know, it's always seen as like, oh, he's a servant. It's like, no, man, he's just a person who wants to create happiness within your life when you come in to this space. That's it. It's some of the fucking most wonderful people in restaurants and hospitality, hotels, like everything, dude. So, you know, bless you guys out there. I hope you're being safe. I hope you're having fun. The last two podcast episodes I dropped was Omri Aflalo, also of Oakland, Jacqueline Dasha, I just dropped yesterday. Shout out to them. She's the CDC of Meadowood. They're doing that event with Cato before Cato even opened. So good for them. And, you know, I got to hang out with one of my closest mentors for a couple of days here in LA, and it was amazing. It was cool to see him be more grounded, and it was cool to know that I had also taught him stuff about himself, you know. And he let me know, man, like, you have a powerful presence, dog. Like, this should not be taken for granted, the fact that you can be a mentor to cooks all over the world with your platform. Like, that's fucking badass, and I'm so grateful that I could be here for all of you. And I hope that you guys tune in more, and I hope that you tell your friends and everybody. And at some point, I'm going to do live shows, and I'd love to see you at the live shows. I think I'm going to call it right now. It's been great to talk to you guys once again. I went on long, but that's okay. I love you with all my heart. Stay true to yourself. Work hard to attain your goals. Work hard to be empathetic towards others, even in stressful times, even if they don't agree with you. Just know, some people just don't know any better. And you need to accept everyone for their faults as well as their highlights. And if we start thinking that way, I feel like we can become a more peaceful society. All right? I'll see you on the flip side. Sucio Talk signing off. It's been a goddamn pleasure to talk today. Sucio Talk. SucioTalk@gmail.com. Don't be afraid to reach out on social. David Sucio. Sucio.talk.podcast on Instagram. Take it day by day. And I'll see you on the next one. Am I right or am I right? Sucio Talk signing off.